Okay, and now, so basically, coming back through this slide, the evolution of basically, it started, as I told you, that it started with analog, yeah? And in 1990 to 2000, evolution from tape-based audio and video to enter digital. So high-definition video captured for viewing and multi-platforms, online to mobile has been the rule of norm for today's broadcasting, you know? So what you've done is capturing on a camera, getting in mobile, online platforms, as well as mobile platforms. With video explosion, it has become necessary abreast with capturing, archiving, and retrieval of digital assets. Multinationals and companies such as Colgate, Palmolive, Bloomberg, Boeing company, everybody wants to get into DAM-MAM solution. Because now they are all into content, yeah? They have to have the edited active programs, the training programs. My friend is the chairman in Boeing. He has everything, all the training programs, and they become the digital assets for the company to go. So it's become very important. Videos, making filmmaking is very important. Digital filmmaking is important for everybody in every walks of life. So be abreast that it's not only the movie industry, I repeatedly say, it is the corporate world which you've got to be prepared for. And you have a big market for that, you know? So RK, you understand DAM is a solution, that is us, and engineering components. So what we actually were planning to do, so it is basically, this is the guys which has to do this, as well a rock and roll library. So has to have audio tapes. No, I actually get records from Canada. The vinyl records, and used to play them, people used to take across. So that time there's vinyl tapes and these records. It moves from analog, then we went to get, then I started a place where I used to make CDs and DVDs. I had this CD writer, 8 megabytes per second kind of thing, 8 frames per second. And that was very big. I opened a shop, I came from Dubai in 96 and opened a shop for interactive CDs. So I bought this CD player, you know, recorders, which is about 50,000 rupees, 60,000. I managed to churn out CDs, games and things. I made a shop order and I did that business for 6 years. So that's how it evolved. I evolved with the system. And it recorded into CDs, DVDs. By the time Blu-rays came, the prices had gone down. So it was not a business to play. So you got a DVD now and then also your Blu-ray players and this mini DVD. But mini DVD, besides that, now there are LTO tapes, which are 4 terabytes, 8 terabytes LTO tapes. So that LTO tapes take right. So now a digital asset management library, what you'll do is you take out a container hard disk or whatever format, take it to the archiving place, then we'll give the content back on the LTO tape, which you can preserve it for 30 years. You know? So the evolution is, this we got, went through the production, this thing, you know, I'm going to ask you. Okay. Now, benefits of DAM, enhanced merchandise license. So now people like what they're doing, like Sony, IPL, everything, they would, because of DAM, they're able to get this content in every stages. Like I told you, different terrestrial, non-terrestrial, all digital, Eros now, Sony Live, live cricket stream. This is all because of digital asset management. They're managing their assets and they're giving them. So it's a sports area. This is free charge is there, alt is there. These are OTT, over the top channels. Yeah, and those are the sports channels. Increase market share through shorter production and distribution cycle. So your production cycle is shorter because of your digital, and your distribution cycles are bigger. You've got various modes of distribution. Improve so that the customer relation acquisition becomes easier. So digital asset management. Okay, I can store in one place, send it to multiple customers, give them multiple rights, or restrict the rights. You know, so it's become a very easy foreign goal. Like you guys are there here, I'm in Dubai, I'm somewhere else. Like I'll tell you, there are people that I work later on. I'm introducing the film school here. It's called Global Television. You know, so in that global, I'll come back to that. Maturity is improve findability, optimize workflow. What will come to workflow? Improve findability is search engines become very easy. In a linear system, I have to see a frame. So you keep on searching. Yeah? You will keep on going through where can I find it till I get that particular clip. Even in editing systems. But abhi kya hai, usko meta tag karke rakhna. Tag, usko each clip, you write a description. you know, Jack jumped from the hill to the well or something like that, or you know, Jill came running after. So you write that particular part of it. Yeah. So all those tags will be able to, when you search it, you'll be able to immediately get to that place. So which what you're doing in Google, it is all tagged content. That is the how the assets are managed. So behind you, like when you're on Facebook, you know, even what you're watching, what you're creating, even on Google or Facebook, you select something, there is somebody tagging you behind. Yeah? And so then it will bring back those dresses or those shoes or those are exactly those two your eyes. And those only you will choose. So you will say, hey, bar bar kyun aate mere paas? And then you will say, yes, let me buy. Because it is judging your movement. You are totally on the, when you are in Google, you are totally exposed. You don't have anything hidden. So this is, added digital asset by making content smart, selling more, one middle across revenue from this is present. RK3 has said over the top, I told you about over the top. HD content is back, archive on the cloud, and only proxy low-res files are made viewable and exportable. So we are coming back to, I talked to you sometime back that he made MPEG-4 files, Apple ProRes files, okay? And from that you have made into MPEG-4 low-res files. Right? PowerPoint. The raw content was in H.264 format. Yeah? Raw content he got from H.264 for editing the Apple ProRes 422. That he blew up into from 1 GB to 24 GB. And when he edit karke wo export kar raha hai, he making it to MPEG-4, which is a lossy compression. And that is a small file which is made into your proxy file. And that proxy is going onto your net for viewing or for, you know. So HD content is backed up on the cloud and only HD content is backed up, only proxy files are made viewable and exported to mobile devices. Now either you can back it up on the cloud or you can keep it in the native server. Native means ghar ka sab, niche wala, ground pe. Otherwise you can have your low-res files which can go across to your mobile, which you find on your mobile. These are all low-res. If you really blow up that file, it will come to, you know, it will get pixelated.